Hi, my name is Michelle Ameerally, and if you'd like to learn more about P3 Theater's Funny Bōnz, watch this video. I first fell in love with theater in high school. I had initially done all of the arts separately. I danced at a dance studio, I sang with a choir, and I did acting in summer camps. And then I discovered musical theater as a freshman in high school. And I realized that I kind of had to do this for the rest of my life because it brought me so much happiness and I could incorporate my love of dance, singing, and acting all into one place. So I had the encouragement of teachers and I took classes and I absolutely just fell in love from that day forward. I didn't stop doing shows. Sketch comedy, it was kind of a hit or miss with me. I was always a little bit intimidated by sketch comedy, and I was asked to audition for a show out of college. I auditioned for a show called John and Juan's Wedding, and it was set up as a workshop versus an actual audition. So we all were improvising as we went. And I really realized that, you know, with the right group of actors, it was fantastically, you know, satisfying. It was really satisfying as an actor to just be able to have a little bit of freedom, yet, you know, keep the other actors on their toes as well. The process that I enjoy most about sketch comedy is that you can really develop a whole different scene from the original scene. And it really is just a matter of working with the right people that you can feed off of back and forth that I enjoy the most. I really like being able to come up with new characters, thinking way outside of the box, and you know, having true, honest feedback. Sometimes a sketch will work, sometimes it won't, but that freedom to have a little bit of fun back and forth with fellow castmates is truly what I love about sketch comedy. Sketch comedy is good for the soul because there's too much serious business happening right now in the world. So it really gives you insight to kind of your inner child, especially if you're doing sketches about, you know, things that are nostalgic to others or even making light of serious situations. It gives you the opportunity to just release that feeling. You know, and it's satisfying. It's happy. You know, right now, especially with coronavirus, we need a little bit of comedy in our life. We need a little bit of happiness. We need a distraction from, you know, watching serious documentaries and analyzing scripts. You know, so sketch comedy gives you that relief. So when I first met some of the members of Laffing Matterz, which was the original troupe, you know, they were very welcoming because I came into Funny Bōnz late in the process, and they were very encouraging. You know, they said, go for it. They were very trusting with my choices, and, you know, feeding off of their energy was, you know, the perfect setting because they were taking risks. They were having fun. They were having fun with voices and accents, and, you know, they really welcomed me as part of their family, even though I had just met a handful of them, on Zoom, you know, minutes before, you know, so I had the opportunity to really just feel right at home right away. And I'm very thankful for that, those original members who welcomed me. I first heard about P3 Theater through John, who is a very close friend of mine. We met in about, I believe, 1999 or 2000. And we met doing a regional tour of Chorus Line. And we remained friends from then on. And so once he opened P3 Theater, I had reached out and I had said, if there's ever anything I can help you with, please let me know. I run a performing arts studio in South Florida and he's in California. So we couldn't collaborate, you know, live. But when Funny Bōnz came around, you know, I had ironically sent him a message a few weeks before just saying, hello, hope all is well, because we all need the help we can get right now in the theater industry. So I was just reaching out and saying hello. And then, they actually had an opportunity for me to jump on board with Funny Bōnz because they had a replacement that they needed to make. And I happily said yes. I was sent a script within, you know, the day, and I just started plowing through it. And then the rest is history. I would say my definition of Funny Bōnz and the Funny Bōnz cast members, we're an eclectic group of actors with incredible talent. There's a lot of talent in that cast, you know, that is definitely going to take people for a ride of laughter. And we're going to push the envelope a little bit with some of our tactics, with some of our sketches. You know, it's a group that everybody enjoys working together and everybody enjoys creating this new virtual theater. I think Funny Bōnz is going to be a great extension to the P3 company. I think even when everything slowly comes back to normal, this is something we could do in addition to live theater, because we can share it with everybody. You'll get to see all the quirky characters that make up our cast, both fictional and non-fictional. And who knows, this can go on for a long time. I think the Funny Bōnz show will be different than what people are used to with Zoom, because John has worked with some great people behind the scenes. We have our sound engineer, Brian, and we're doing everything that we can to make it seem like we're live together on stage. So we're all recording in different segments. We're recording with green screens, then we're recording the voices, then we're recording the songs. So it's kind of a multi-layered event, which makes it more exciting, because it's not what we're used to, where we're going to see everybody in boxes and, you know, having that kind of Zoom/WebEx show. It's going to be more like a real collaboration. It's going to look like we're all together. And it took some practice, and it took a lot of, you know, understanding the technical side. So we're all becoming more versed in what microphones work best, what earbuds work best, you know, what's VMix versus Zoom. So it's going to be fun. It's going to look like we're all together and enjoying a show versus the typical skits that we're seeing right now with Zoom. What I would like the audience to get out of the Funny Bōnz experience is pure joy. I want them to take an hour out of their day and not think about the bills, not think about cooking dinner, not think about, you know, what our country has been going through, whether it's politics or coronavirus or, you know, everything, you know, past, present, future. So just literally take a good solid chunk out of the day and laugh, you know, and I want them to enjoy the performance and not overly think about it. Just say, oh, that was funny. Oh, that was very entertaining. I'd like to see more. So if we can make the world escape for an hour or two and enjoy themselves without taking anything too seriously, then we've done our job, because right now that's what we need. We need a little smiling, a little laughter, and a new fresh start to 2021. What I hope for the future of Funny Bōnz is that there's a nice combination of live and virtual. Hopefully we can continue a virtual stream for those of us that want to work together that are in different cities. But hopefully Funny Bōnz can, you know, take hold in a theater at P3 in California, and then maybe Rita can open one up again down here in South Florida. You know, there's lots of major cities and we're all spread out. You know, we are in Orlando, South Florida, Chicago, New York, California, and Texas. So if there could be a Funny Bōnz, you know, a flagship at P3 in California, and then open up a few smaller ones, I think it'd be great. And I think it'd be very successful, because comedy clubs, you know, have been going on forever, and sketch comedy mixed with dinner, similar to Laffing Matterz, is always going to be a successful gig, because people want to take breaks from reality. People want to just enjoy a cocktail, a quick dinner, and be entertained. And I think that's the best part of it. You know, we can make Funny Bōnz grow, like I said, live and virtual. I think that's what I would like to see the future of Funny Bōnz be. Viewers should attend the P3 Funny Bōnz experience, because you need to all relax and have fun. They should sit back, enjoy the show. And, you know, I'd love the feedback. This is not something I've done for a long time. And I think if we get, you know, requests for new sketches and new characters, you know, I think people would truly enjoy that. I think they should watch it with their family, not their kids, but maybe their family members, their sisters. They could watch it virtually together and text back and forth what they liked and what they didn't like. I think it'd be a fun event for them. I think theaters like the P3 community and all local theaters and venues are so important, because it creates a creative outlet for both the performers and the audience. I think the reason we all enjoy live theater is because there's an energy that you feel both in the audience and on stage that is really not easy to explain unless you're there in the moment, especially live theater and comedy. You know, there's something about laughing in the moment with that person on stage. You know, sometimes actors break character and that's even funnier. Sometimes the audience will find things funny that you didn't think were that funny. So that back and forth energy is what's needed right now in our world. You know, a lot of times we spend everything communicating through cell phones. And we even laugh and we'll say laugh out loud, and we're not laughing. We're just writing laugh out loud. So we forget to actually emote as people. So live theater to me is something that I believe will make a full comeback, but it's crucial. I think it's crucial for socialization. It's crucial for our children, and it's crucial for just having that human feeling back and forth. Hi, my name is Michelle Ameerally, and if you enjoyed this conversation about Funny Bōnz, come see our show. We'd love to see you there.